فؤادك الأيام فتى.
تعريف أصول الفقه فصل.
The Sheikh رحمه الله تعالى in this chapter he's going to define أصول الفقه for us. What أصول الفقه means. So تعريف means what? Definition of أصول أصول الفقه. The definition of أصول الفقه. فصل unit.
أصول الفقه هي العلم بأدلة الفقه الكلية.
Now the issue of looking and observing أصول الفقه. When we speak about أصول الفقه, the way we define it, فتعريف ينقسم إلى قسمين. Everyone has to understand this. The defining of أصول الفقه, when you want to define it, you have to categorize it into two. First of all, you define it. The first type of defining it is بِاعْتِبَارِ مُفْرَدَيْهِ. Looking at the word as a what? That it's إضافة. That the word is a مضافة and a مضاف إليه. Which is أصول الفقه. So what you're going to do is what? You're going to separate both of them from one another. So the first one is separate أصول and then فقه from it. So define أصول by itself and then define فقه. That's the first type. That's the first way of defining it. The second way of defining it is what? بِاعْتِبَارِ عَلَمًا عَلَى هَذَا الْفَنِّ الْمُعَيَّنِ, which is that it's عَلَمِيَّة. You define it as together as a field, as the field أصول الفقه. So what does it mean as a whole now? So now let me inshallah ta'ala do that. I'm going to define أصل by itself or أصول by itself, and then I'm going to define فقه by itself, and then I'm going to define both of them together. So what does أصول mean linguistically? The word usul, first of all, is a plural. And the singular of it is asl. Usul is a plural. It's jam'u taksir, a broken plural. The singular is asl. That's the singular. In the Arabic language, linguistically, the word asl is al-asas alladhi yubna alayhi ghayru. It is the foundation. Asas means asl means the foundation. In which everything is built on. This house that we live in, the asas is the floor. Everything is built on top of it. Now, pay attention. The asas is two types. The foundations are two types. Foundation which is tangible. It is what? It's tangible. Hissiyan, something you can put your hand on. Which is like what? Like the walls. Like the roof. All of these are the asas of the house, the foundation of the house. Are you with me? There's also a foundation which is, it's not hissiyan, it's aqliyan, logically. It's a foundation. Such as what? Like, for example, a ruling on an evidence. A ruling on an evidence. That is what, that is meant by. The ruling is, the ruling, what's the asas for this ruling? The evidence. Now, what does asal mean technically? Linguistically, we understood it. It means al-asas alladhi yubna alayhi ghayru. We've understood it. And we've also learned that asal is the singular of usul. Good. We're now going to take the technical meaning of the word asal. The word asal technically means a handful of meanings. A handful of meanings, not only one meaning. It comes in many meanings, not only one meaning. One, it means sometimes evidence. Sometimes the word asal technically means what? Dalil, evidence. For example, the ulama will say, aslu hadhihi al-mas'ala al-kitab wa-sunnah. The evidence of this matter. So asal here, they mean what? Evidence. The evidence of this matter is the kitab and the sunnah. A daliluha. For example, somebody will come up to you and say to you, aslu wujub al-salah. The asal, that the salah is wajib, is qawluhu ta'ala, the statement of Allah, wa aqimu salah, establish the prayer, ay dalilu, it's evidence. Very good. The second one is al-qa'idatil kulliyatil mustamirra. The consistent principle. The principle that is always continuous, ongoing principle. It's also known as asal. What does that mean? إباحة الميتة, the permissibility of the dead, للمضطر, for the one who is in a position of necessity. It's what? على خلاف الأصل. it goes against the asal. What asal does it go against? It goes against the qa'idat al-kulliyat al-mustamirra. It goes against the principle that was consistent, which is that, that this is haram. That this is what? It was haram. The qa'idah said that whatever Allah prohibits, it's haram. You went against the qa'idah that was ever going. And it's also like the statement of the Arab, the scholars when they say, al-yaqeenu la yazulu bishak. Aslun min usul al-shari'ah. Meaning they mean the qa'idah al-kulliyah. The third meaning that it comes in is al-rujhan. Al-rujhan. It comes in the meaning of al-rujhan. Ma ma'ana al-rujhan? Al-rujhan means when a thing can take one of two meanings, but the strongest of the two is this one. For example, al-aslu fil kalam al-haqiqa. The asal of any speech is that you take it at its literal, in its reality. That you don't say it's a metaphor or it's a simile or no. You take it at its literal meaning. For example, if I tell you today, for example, if I say to you today, Ra'aytu asadan, Ra'aytu asadan, I saw a lion. You have to understand my word literal. But if I say to you, Ra'aytu asadan yakhtub, I saw a lion giving khutbah, there's a qarina. Within the sentence, there's something that diverted it from its literal, which is the word, yakhtub. A lion doesn't do khutbah. So automatically you understand what I mean is that I saw a brave individual giving a khutbah. But the asal is what? So if two people argue, one says to Akhi, this is majaz. And another one says, La Akhi, this is haqiqa. Who takes precedence? The one who's upon the asal. He takes precedence. And that brings us back, that brings us to another meaning that it has, which is al-maqisu alayh. The asal is the maqisu alayh. Remember when we studied qiyas, how many pillars did we say that the qiyas has? How many? Four. Very good, mashallah. What were they? So we said asal, ana fara, ana hukum, ana illa. Four, right? So the asal is the one that the qiyas is being done from. You just mentioned four, right? You just said asal, fara, hukum, ana illa. Those are four pillars for qiyas, right? Analogy. And then the asal is the one you're going to do the analogy from. Remember when we were talking about khamar and nabid? The nabid is the fara'. The khamar is the what? The asal. It's the thing that you're doing the analogy from. It's called asal. Na'am, asal. The last one is al-istishab. Istishab. Istishab means what? بقاء ما كان على ما كان. And it's somebody pours water over you. And you're walking on the road, and somebody just pours a bucket of water over you. Are you with me? So, you didn't know who poured it over you, which house it was, you didn't know. And you're walking. Now, do we take this water as pure or impure? We go back to the asal. What's the asal of the water? This is called istishab. We go to its original form. So we say, what was the original form of the water when Allah sent it down? Allah says, He sent down, أَنْزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً طَهُورًا. Allah sent water which is pure. The water is pure in its essence. So, the qa'idah is what? الْأَصْلُ الطَّهَارَةُ فِي كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. The asl is everything is pure until proven its impurity. If I go to a place, I can pray unless you prove to me this place is impure. If I see a water, I'm allowed to do tahara with it because the water is tahir. It's pure. Na'am. This is called what? Istishab. So we've now taken the linguistic and the technical meaning of the word asal. We understood asal. We're now going to move on to fiqh. We're now going to move on to the word fiqh. Fiqh, what does it mean? It means al-fahmu. The word fiqh means what? Al-fahmu, to understand something. Understanding something is called what? It's a fiqh. And sometimes the fiqh is called what? Ilm, knowledge. Sometimes knowledge, you can call it fiqh. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said in the Quran about Nabiullah Hud alayhi salam. That Hud alayhi salam, what did he say? قالوا يا شعيب ما نفقه كثيرا مما تقول. They said about Nabiullah Hud that we don't understand a lot of the things that you say. ما نفقه أي ما نفهمه. Also Allah تبارك وتعالى He said فما لهؤلاء القوم لا يكادون يفقهون قولا. Who are these people? Haditha, sorry. فما لهؤلاء القوم لا يكادون يفقهون حديثا. What are these people who are unable to comprehend? يفقهون أي يفهمون. Also Nabiullah Musa عليه السلام when he made the dua, he asked Allah تبارك وتعالى رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي أي يفهم قولي. That's what he said. Also Allah تبارك وتعالى he told us that the angels يسبحون الليل والنهار لا يفطرون. That the angels, they always exalt Allah. Also everything they do what? وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا يُسَبِّحُ بِحَمْدِهِ. They praise Allah and they glorify Him. وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ تَصْبِيحَهُمْ. But you guys are unable to understand there. وَلَكِنْ لَا تَفْقَهُونَ. You guys are unable to what? You guys are unable to understand their praising of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then that's what it means linguistically. It means fahm. It means what? It means fahm. Very good. Now, what does it mean technically? What does the word fiqh technically mean? The word fiqh technically means, according to the ulama of the sharia, they understand the word fiqh as what? They understand the word fiqh as ma'rifatu al-ahkam al-shar'iyyah al-amaliyyah al-muktasaba min adillatiha al-tafsiliyyah. It is ma'rifa. It is to know. Ma'rifa here means what? It means al-ilmu wa-dhannu al-rajih. It means what? Ilm, knowledge and high assumption. The ma'rifa, that's what the sheikh used, ma'rifa. That's what the scholars, they use ma'rifa. The word ma'rifa is what? Ma'rifa is understanding, whether by way of knowledge or by high assumption. So in our religion, do we give high assumption a position? Na'am. We base hukum on dhannul ghalib. We do. What's the evidence for that? The evidence for that is, if a person testifies that he saw the crescent, he saw the moon, he saw the hilal, do we take his word for it? And he's a reliable person. Yes, but there's a possibility he can get it wrong. Dhannul ghalib. Dhannul ghalib is what we're basing our hukum on here right now. And knowledge, of course, we base it on the knowledge as well. Very good. And also, وَالْأَحْكَامْ الشَّرْعِيَّةِ. أحكام الشرعية معرفة الأحكام الشرعية. What does أحكام الشرعية mean? It is أحكام الثابتة في الشرع that are taken from the شريعة. So, what can't be in here? أحكام العقلية is not in here. أحكام الحسية is not in here. أحكام الوضعية is not in here. أحكام الوضعية doesn't fall here. أحكام الوضعية means what? It doesn't mean the one that أصول الفقه speak about. There's difference between أحكام الشرعية الوضعية and أحكام الوضعية. It's two different. أحكام الوضعية is any حكم you and I both place, such as the ulama of grammar, they place, this is called فعل. Where do you get this from? This is فاعل. It's a حكم. And if the فاعل does this, this is what happens. And if فاعل مفعول looks like this. These are حكم وضعي. They're placed by the people of that field. أحكام العقلية, which is to know that half, two halves make a full. Two halves make a full. That's aql. That's ahkam, but it's aql. There's also ahkam al-hissiyya, tangible ahkam, which is that the fire can burn you. You don't need aql for that. Ahkam al-hissiyya. All of those are what? All of those are not what we're talking about. We're talking about al-ahkam al-shar'iyyah al-taklifiyyah and ahkam al-shar'iyyah al-wad'iyyah. Those two. And also we said what? Ma'rifat al-ahkam al-shar'iyyah. Al-amaliyyah. It has to be actions. What leaves? Such as salah, zakat and buyu'. What leaves? Ahkam al-ilmiyyah. Ahkam al-ilmiyyah are what? Masail al-ilmiyyah are tawheed. Tawheed. They're not the matters we're talking about here. We're talking about matters pertaining to actions only. And then after that, what did the scholar say? Al-muqtasaba. That is benefited. Where do we benefit it from? We benefit from it from the specified text evidences, which we're going to bring later, inshallah. So, ma'rifatul ahkam al-shar'iyya al-amaliyya al-muqtasaba. That's benefited from where? Min adillatiha al-tafsiliyya. Adilla tafsiliyya means what? Adilla tafsiliyya. First of all, we have to realize that adilla are two types. Adilla ijmaliyya and adilla tafsiliyya. Who deals with adilla ijmaliyya? Usul al-fiqh deals with adilla ijmaliyya. What's adilla ijmaliyya? Comprehensive evidences. Adilla tafsiliyya means what? Detailed evidences. Detailed evidences. So, adilla ijmaliyya is usul al-fiqh. Adilla tafsiliyya is fiqh. An example of adilla ijmaliyya, ama dalil tafsili. So, because we're talking about here fiqh. Dalil tafsili here is like if I say to you, ولا تقربوا الزنا. Don't get close to zina. This is a dalil juz'i, specific on the matter pertaining to hurmatu zina. Is this not a narrowed down evidence? It is a narrowed down evidence. But what about if I say to you, al-amru taqtadi al-wujub? A command shows what? A command shows obligation. This is a evidence which is general. You can use it for zina. The fact that you ordered to stay away from it, you can use it for salah, you can use it for zakat. It's a dalil which is ijmali. That's usul al-fiqh. Lakin, fiqh is what? Tafsili. So, what have we done right now? What we've done right now is, we've defined usul al-fiqh bi-i'tibari mufradayhi, singularly. We looked at it singular. We looked at usul and we looked at fiqh. We looked at usul by itself, and we looked at fiqh by itself. Now what do we have to do? The second way, which is to look at usul al-fiqh as a field which is together. And the sheikh is going to do that. So there won't be a need for me to do that. Even that though, I defined it when I was talking about what? The mabadi al-ashar. Naam. Naam.
هي العلم بأدلة الفقه الكلية وذلك أن الفقه إما مسائل يطلب الحكم عليها بأحد الأحكام الخمسة وإما دلائل يستدل بها على هذه المسائل فالفقه هو معرفة المسائل والدلائل وهذه الدلائل نوعان.
شيخ رحمه الله said the first point we studied, which is أصول الفقه, is what? هي العلم بأدلة الفقه الكلية. That is what أصول الفقه, the Sheikh defined it as. أصول الفقه to the Sheikh is what? العلم بأدلة الفقه الكلية. When he said العلم, so أصول الفقه to him is what? العلم, knowledge. So when he said knowledge, what does he mean by that? He means العلم وظن الراجح. But we used a better word, which was what? معرفة, is to know. That would have been better. And he said, بِأَدِلَّةِ الْفِقْهِ. The evidences. Adilla is what? Adilla is plural and the singular is dalil. Dalil is the singular. What is a dalil? Dalil is هُوَ الْمُرْشِدُ. It is the one that guides you إِلَى الْمَطْلُوبِ, to the thing that you want. أَوْ مَا يَحْصُلُ بِهِ الْإِرْشَادِ كَعَلَامَةِ الْمُرْشِدَةِ لِأَمْرٍ مَا. It is anything that makes you reach something which you want, something which you're looking for. This is called what? A dalil. And the plural for the word dalil is what? Adilla. Al-fiqh al-kulliyya. Al-fiqh al-juz'iyya is the other one. Ama, fiqh al-kulliyya means the comprehensive fiqh. So usul al-fiqh, the difference that you need to underline is what? Usul al-fiqh deals with what? Comprehensive evidences. Whereas fiqh only deals with what? Detailed, narrowed down evidences. Naam. And then the sheikh said, وَذَٰلِكَ. That ishara, ذَٰلِكَ, it refers back to what? أي الفقه. وَذَٰلِكَ أي الفقه. The fiqh is two types. The sheikh is telling us fiqh is two types. You just underline those words in your book, everybody, inshallah ta'ala. What is it? مسائل or دلائل. Those are the two. Underline the word مسائل and the word دلائل. Those are the two types. So the sheikh is telling you that fiqh is two types. It is either masail or dala'il. Now I'm going to explain to you what he means by the masail or the dala'il. The masail or the dala'il is as follows. The mas'ala is that the salah is wajib. Is that not a mas'ala? Wujubu salah is a mas'ala that you found out, which is that the salah is obligatory. Very good. And the dala'il is that which showed you, that which has shown you the ruling, which is the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, وَأَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةَ, establish the prayer. It is what? The thing that I used for the salah to be wajib, this is what the sheikh said. Na'am. So, وَذَلِكَ, and that it is, أَنَّ الْفِقْهَ, that the fiqh is, إِمَّا مَسَائِلٌ, it is either masail, such as wujubu salah, يُطْلَبُ الْحُكْمُ, the hukum is requested. عَلَيْهَا, يُطْلَبُ الْحُكْمُ عَلَيْهَا, the hukum is requested on it through the one of the five. And I just mentioned wujubu salah, right? You can talk about all the five, ahkamu taklifi that we're going to come to later, inshallah ta'ala. The five that we're going to come to, inshallah ta'ala, which are al-wajib, al-mundub, al-makruh, al-haram, al-mubah. Those are the five he's referring to here. They are what? Anything that you say wajib, anything which you say haram, anything you say makruh, anything you say masnoon, anything like that, these are masail, mas'alatun, mas'alatun, mas'ala. The dala'il is what? Wa dala'ilu. Wa amma dala'ilu. As for the dala'il, yustadallu, dala'ilu yustadallu biha ala hadhihi al-masail. It is the ability, it is the malaka, the ability to extract, it is the ability to extract istinbat wa istikhraj al-ahkam min al-kitab wa sunnah. It is the ability to extract from the kitab and the sunnah, with this evidence that you have, the ruling that it's wajib or it's sunnah. Na'am. So the sheikh then wanted to say, فَالْفِقْهُ, فِقْه, هُوَ مَعْرِفَةُ الْمَسَائِلِ وَالدَّلَائِلِ. That's what it is. Those are the two. The masail is what? The five. Wajib, mandub, makruh, haram, mubah. That's the mas'ala. That you can know that this is wajib, that this is mandub, that this is makruh, that this is haram and this is mubah. That's a mas'ala. And also the dala'il is what? The ayah that you have and the hadith which you have, the sunnah. How to go and to extract this matter from it, it is called dala'il yustadallu biha ala hadhihi al-masail. Na'am.
وَهَذِهِ الدَّلَائِلُ نَوْعَانِ.
So the dala'il are two types now. So now the sheikh rahimahullah ta'ala, what is he going to do? He's going to explain for us what are the dala'il. There are two types. You have to understand these points. Na'am. The first one is what?
Kulliyatun.
The first one is comprehensive. The first type of dala'il are two types. So the dala'il are two types. The first one is kulliyatun. It is what? It is kulliyatun, comprehensive. Na'am.
تَشْمَلُ كُلَّ حُكْمٍ مِّن جِنْسٍ وَاحِدٍ مِّنْ أَوَّلِ الْفِقْهِ إِلَىٰ آخِرِهِ.
It means that all of every ruling, كُلُّ حُكْمٍ, every ruling, مِّن جِنْسٍ وَاحِدٍ, which all of them have the same essence. From the first book of fiqh to the ending, they all share with each other what? Any chapter you go to, where you find that a ayah or a hadith explicitly says that you have to do something, from the first chapter to the end of the chapter, this is the dalil, which is kulli al-amru lil-wujub wal-nahyu lil-tahrim, that you have to do this. Is this specific to a particular chapter? So it's kulli, right? It goes into every chapter. That's the first one. Every chapter of fiqh, from tahara, salah, zakah, hajj, sawm, it doesn't matter. Every one of them, when there comes a amr from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala in that matter, you can use this issue, this qa'ida, which is al-amru lil-wujub wa nahyu lil-tahrim. Hayya.
كَقَوْلِنَا الْأَمْرُ لِلْوُجُوبِ وَالنَّهْيُ لِلْتَحْرِيمِ وَنَحْوِهِمَا وَهَذِهِيَ أُصُولُ الْفِقْهِ.
Learn this again. So that one is called usul al-fiqh. You see, before I explain it to you guys, so the difference between usul al-fiqh and fiqh, what is the difference? This is dala'il kulliya. Usul al-fiqh is what? He's going to tell you adilla juz'iyya. That's the difference. This is specific fiqh, whereas usul al-fiqh is comprehensive. You can start from them in awwal kitab al-fiqh ila akhirih, to the ending, all of them, you can use this qa'ida with you. Al-amru lil-wujub wa nahyu lit-tahrim, you can apply every place. As soon as you find the Prophet commanded something, you can say to the person, akhi, did the Prophet command it? Huh? Akhi, the adilla in here is what? That is wajib. Where's? You see? Naam.
Wa adillatun juz'iyyatun tafsiliyya.
The second one is adilla, which is specific. It's a what? It's specific. Adilla, ha. It's adilla juz'iyya tafsiliyya. It's tafsiliyya and juz'iyya are the same. They are both specific. Naam.
تفتقر إلى أن تبنى على الأدلة الكلية.
تفتقر means what? It needs. تفتقر, it needs. It requires. إلى أن تبنى, for it to be built on top of it. على الأدلة الكلية. The أدلة الكلية that you had, you're going to build on top of that. So the person already knows الأمر للوجوب. والنهي للتحريم. He has that with him. He's holding it on his hand. And now he needs this. Adilla kulliya requires from you what? This adilla kulliya requires from you a adilla tafsiliya you can place it on. So what's adilla tafsiliya? The minute you say waqimu salah, now you've narrowed down the evidence that you're using it for. Because when you say aqimu salah, is it, does it fall under zakat? Nope. So the adilla tul kulliya is built on top of the adilla tul tafsiliya. Naam.
فَإِذَا تَمَّتْ حُكْمَ عَلَى الْأَحْكَامِ بِهَا.
And so what will happen? فَإِذَا تَمَّتْ, when they become complete. So I said right now, which one is built on which? Is the tafsiliyya built on the kulliyya, or is the kulliyya built on the tafsiliyya? That is the two methodologies that were set by the ulama. According to the Hanafis, they have a tariqah. The Hanafis believe what? Different to the belief of the Jumhur. The Jumhur, when they look at Usul al-Fiqh, which one is built on which one? They believe that the Tafsiliyya is built upon the Kulliyya, the Jumhur. Whereas vice versa is what the Hanafis believe. Naam. فَإِذَا تَمَّتْ, if it becomes complete. حُكِمَ عَلَى الْأَحْكَامِ بِهَا, the Ahkam would be given a ruling on it. Then you say it's wajib, akhi. You have to do this. And this is, which type is this one? Which one is adilla to juz'iyya? The sheikh should have said, وَهَذِهِ هِيَ الْفِقْهِ. But he didn't say that. He should have said what? He should have said, وَهَذِهِ هِيَ الْفِقْهِ. At the ending. So the student of knowledge, because the first one he said to him what? The first one he said to him, وَهَذِهِ هِيَ أُصُولُ الْفِقْهِ, right? He said to him, وَهَذِهِ هِيَ الْفِقْهِ. And this is fiqh. That's what he should have said. نعم.
فَالْأَحْكَامُ مُضْطَرَّةٌ إِلَىٰ أَدِلَّتِهَا التَّفْصِيلِيَّةِ.
So the ahkam is in need. مُطَّرَّةٌ. What does مُطَّرَّةٌ mean? It's in need. The ahkam, the rulings are in need of what? إِلَىٰ أَدِلَّتِهَا التَّفْصِيلِيَةِ. If you learn أَدِلَّ كُلِّيَّةِ and you haven't studied usul al-fiqh, where are you going to apply these qawa'id and these principles on? Where are you going to apply it? You need to go to the books, learn the ahkam, and then be able to apply it. Apply it. Apply it. Apply it. نعم. Because they need each other.
وَالْأَدِلَّةُ التَّفْصِيلِيَّةُ مُضْطَرَّةٌ إِلَى الْأَدِلَّةِ الْكُلِّيَّةِ.
So the usuli needs the faqih, and the faqih needs the usuli. They know they both need each other. You see? The adilla kulliyyah needs the adilla tafsiliyyah. They need each other. Naam. So it's important, and it shows us the need of having to study usul al-fiqh. You see? وَلِذَلَكَ شَيْخُ الْإِسْلَامِ بِنُ تَيْمِيَةِ said his مَجْمُوعَ الْفَتَاوَى, the 20th volume, page 497, Ibn Taymiyyah said, المقصود من أصول الفقه, the intent behind أصول الفقه is what? أن يفقه مراد الله, is to understand Allah's intention behind things. ورسولي and his messenger, بالكتاب والسنة, in the book of Allah and the Sunnah. We want to understand what Allah means by this. What does the Prophet ﷺ mean by this? That's what we want. So that shows us that this field, the fa'idah is a lot and it's excessive. And remember, I gave you guys the benefits that were mentioned. Naam.
وَبِهَذَا نَعْرِفُ الضُّرُورَةَ وَالْحَاجَةَ إِلَىٰ مَعْرِفَةَ إلى معرفة أصول الفقه.
And based on that, based on that, based on what? Based on that which I have, what I've already solidified and explained to you, which is what? That the ahkam مضطرة إلى أدلتها التفصيلية والأدلة التفصيلية مضطرة إلى الأدلة الكلية. That which I said shows you and allows you to know that what? That ضرورة والحاجة, the need. So pay attention. Are you all with me? The sheikh said ضرورة and he said حاجة. And I explained this in قواعد الفقهية when I was teaching it. What's the difference between ضرورة and حاجة? The difference between ضرورة and حاجة is that the ضرورة is what? You have no alternatives. This is the only option you have. But you need it badly. حاجة, you need it badly as well. But you've got all other alternatives. You have what? Other alternatives. You have other things you can do. So أصول الفقه is, it's ضرورة and it's حاجة. إلى معرفة أصول الفقه, to learn أصول الفقه. نعم.
وأنها معينة عليه وهي أساس النظر والاجتهاد في الأحكام.
And that it helps. أصول الفقه is what? معينة, it helps. Helps on what? It helps you upon على الفقه وأحكامه. It helps you. معينة means it supports you, it aids you. Aids me on what? It aids you on fiqh and its rulings. You want to study a fiqh book? أصول الفقه will aid you, help you. وهي أساس النظر, and it is the foundation of wanting to observe the sharia. If you want to look at things, you want to research, that's the asas. أصول الفقه is the asas. Well, ijtihadu, and it's also the asas of doing ijtihad in matters of ahkam. It is what? Usul al-fiqh is. We finished the first fasl. We finished the first fasl. Na'am.